Mr. Peter Okondo, who's also Parliamentary Secretary to the Treasury. Mr. Okondo, from your knowledge of Jomo Kenyatta, what sort of role do you think he'll play in Kenya's politics?
I think Kenyatta understands the African mind much better than most leaders do, and I think he'll play a very important role. He understands that with the African way of doing things, you must achieve a consensus of opinion amongst the people, as opposed to the method, the Westminster method of a majority of one by vote.
Do you think that Mr. Kenyatta will want to enter Parliament, or that he'll want to remain a sort of father figure with a view to becoming possibly the president of an East African Federation?
As far as I know, Mr. Kenyatta, I think he's likely to take things slowly first, to sort of find his level with the people. Although he's remarkably abreast with the present circumstances, but his move yesterday or so shows that he isn't likely to just plunge in. He wants his period of time to sort of readjust himself.
What chance do you think Mr. Kenyatta will have of bringing together the two African nationalist parties, KADU and KANU?
I think the majority of KANU and KADU will unite under Mr. Kenyatta. He has quite a big chance. But naturally, he's a human being like all of us, and everybody may not necessarily agree with his methods. And there might very well be a splinter group. But I think the majority of both parties are most likely to work with him. Because, as I pointed out earlier, his method of getting people to work, to agree by consensus, does remove bitterness that is often engendered by vote in that minority.
How much African support is there for Mr. Kenyatta among, for instance, the small pastoral tribes?
I would say that outside the Kikuyu areas, support for Mr. Kenyatta isn't as strong as one finds in and around Nairobi. But most of the educated people do realize that we want a leader of his caliber.
Again, from your knowledge of Mr. Kenyatta, what would you say are his political ideals?
His political ideals, I think, as far as I knew him in 51 and 52, are very, very democratic. He wants a country to be run by a straight democratic system.
The white settlers in Kenya, to most of whom Kenyatta's name still has Mau Mau associations, have gradually become either reconciled or resigned to the idea of his release. Now, even this represents quite a remarkable change of opinion in quite a short time. And to discuss the reasons for it,